that you don't forget. Cause the war's not over when the fighting ends. There's a part of me that will always be just a boy in a hole with an M16. Airborne Ranger Infantry. I left my best friend lying in a pool of blood while I crawled away through the brush and mud. If I could choose to go back again, I'd die lying there next to him. Still see his face when I close my eyes. There's a part of me that will always be just a boy in a hole with an M16. Airborne Ranger.
User joined your channel.
My brothers who died right next to me. And all we ask is that you don't forget. Cause the war's not over when the fighting ends. There's a part of us that will always be just boys in a hole with our M16s.
Softly creeping, left its scenes while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain still.
User was moved to your channel. User was moved to your channel. Alright, so for those of you who don't know, go ahead and get yourselves on training server 1. Once you are there, take a normal trooper slot and then just hang tight where you are.
Icarus,
everybody.
Can you drag Heartshock?
Yeah, stand by.
Alright, all my guard, just keep yourselves lined up. Make it look real pretty. I'm gonna just be double checking things, making sure everything is where it's supposed to.
Where is Heartshock at?
He just PM'd me on TeamSpeak. I'm scrolling to find him. He's in a chat room, yeah.
Oh, hold on.
Right, I'm here.
Alright, so just to make sure everyone's on the same page, when the memorial starts in 10 minutes, if you are not going to be saying anything super major, if you're not going to be speaking, make sure to mute your mics, that way we don't have any kind of anonymous chatter or noise in the background. This is due to the fact that Corvo will be streaming whole thing. We want to make sure it's as and recording, so we'll make sure this is as pretty as humanly possible. Regardless, the point still stands.
Hey Grim, a lot of your fence posts got knocked over randomly.
I'll fix it in just a second.
User joined your channel. Never saw granddaddy down here. User joined your channel.
Currently parsing something for us to use. Alright, Cosmere, I'm not sure if you briefed your pilots. Basically, when you guys are ready to go, I'm going to give you guys a nice little 5-minute spool-up time to get your guys sorted. Get up in the air. You'll be seeing that there is a holding area to the south of Stratus. Basically, get yourselves up in the air and get there. All the F-16s have full fuel tanks, so you guys shouldn't have to worry about burning too quickly. Once you're there, I'll be giving you basically a minute outdoor or a minute out call so that you guys can get ready to come in.
Okay. I'm not seeing that on the map, by the way.
The server died. I will fix.
Thank you.
I just need to bring this up and I need. Alright, you should see on the map now, Cosme.
Okay.
It'll give you guys a little bit of leeway room.
Alright, so you, which direction do you want us to head towards? Fly right over Stratus Airbase?
Yeah, basically, okay. You're gonna go basically from like south to north, essentially.
Got it.
I volunteered for the Army.
So, Grim.
Yes.
Are we doing... I know we're getting into, with the Honor Guard, we're getting pretty heavily into DNC. Are we doing shoulder arms and all that shit, too?
Can't do that in Arma.
Kinda can. You can put your weapon on your back. Do a kind of right shoulder. Not exactly, but it's close. Plus you can get with Arma anyway.
What server?
Training server 1 for those of you who will be joining strictly into server. Otherwise, if you want to just listen in on TeamSpeak, you can just hang out in TeamSpeak.
Does anybody want to throw it on the main, the Cav Discord, so it's publicly announced?
It has been. It has been. We just didn't tag anyone.
Okay.
And I'm about to send a message to those on tech too.
You might want to move Fisher to the main area. He's in the lineup zone, field, whatever.
Fisher in here with us.
Question, out of the people that are streaming, is anyone going to take a screenshot as well?
And alright, my honor guard, you guys can go ahead and throw your rifles on your back. Go ahead and get that sorted. Everything else should be moving pretty. Words up, got tabs up.
Here's a friendly reminder. Until you're speaking, if you have voice activation, please mute yourself. This is going to be an anchor off environment.
Connecting everything. Accordingly, and good evening, Mr. Chance. How goes it?
It's going. Thanks for asking.
Are we moving from here, or are we just standing still for now?
You're gonna just be hanging tight while everyone else gets in.
Roger that.
And the one thing I will say to everyone here, once you guys are in there and you walk past it, there's a uniforms box as you guys walk out. That is going to have earplugs in it because they did not make it into the loadouts when the map was pushed over. And this way none of you go deaf. So when we go to walk out, just make sure you grab them as you go. Don't take too long, it's just earplugs. And then just continue walking as per normal.
Since we're acre off, will that matter?
Yes and no, because you'll still hear it. It'll private still be class, really nasty tinnitus.
Private first class Hilton T, you're hot biking.
Sorry, buddy.
Alright, Graham, I went and got everybody I could possibly get a hold of.
Awesome. Yep, remember if you guys have voice activation on, what I'm really looking for is people who know that they'll be speaking or people of officer status can go ahead and keep their mics unmuted, especially if you plan on talking during it. Otherwise, if you know you have voice act on, just keep yourself muted just for the sake that nothing comes across that shouldn't come across. We're trying to make this as official as humanly possible. One could tell by how he walked that he drunk more than his share. He fumbled round until he could no longer keep his feet. And he stumbled off into the grass to sleep beside the street. Ring ding diddle little idio, ring da diddly io. He stumbled off into the grass to sleep beside the street. About that time two young and lovely girls just happened by. One says to the other with a twinkle in her eye, see yon sleeping Scotsman so strong and handsome build. I wonder if it's true what they don't wear beneath the kilt. Ring ding diddle little idio, ring da diddly io. I wonder if it's true what they don't wear. They crept up on
just slight problems here, trying to get it to fix itself. Give me one second here. And there, behold, for them to view beneath his Scottish skirt was nothing more than God had graced him with upon his birth. Ring ding diddle little idio, ring da diddly io, was nothing more than God had graced him with upon his birth. They marveled for a moment, then one said, we must be gone. Let's leave a present for our friend before we move along. As a gift they left a blue silk ribbon tied into a bow. Around the bonny star the Scots kilt did lift and show. Ring ding diddle little idio, ring da diddly io. Around the bonny star.
All right, that's all tested and works. Fantastic. Scotsman woke to nature's call and stumbled towards the trees. Behind the bush he lifts his kilt and gawks at what he sees. And in a startled voice he says to what's before his eyes, oh, lad, I don't know where you've been, but I see you won first prize. Ring ding diddle little idio, ring da diddly idio. Oh, lad, I don't know where you've been, but I see you won first prize. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and start moving everybody. So, everyone who is attending, if you have grabbed your earplugs, go ahead and form up behind the honor guard in a single file, if you'd be so kind. User joined your we're going to start moving people towards the assembly area. Once we're there, other people can form in behind as we go there. Alright, Lucy, take them out. Everyone make sure you're on walking pace. We're going to make this look as pretty as humanly possible.
Where's the crate with those earplugs?
That's the uniform crate by the edge of the concrete barriers.
Here's your notification. Streaming is beginning now. I go up some days I don't want to come down. Well, I fly that plane. Call the angel flight. Come on, brother, you're with me tonight. Between heaven and earth, you're never alone. On the angel flight, come on, brother, I'm taking you.
Those of you in attendance, go ahead and form up in the rows facing the memorial. My honor guard are moving towards the far corner. Come on, brother, I'm taking you home. Come on.
church in here tonight. It don't matter where we touch down. On the angel flight, it's sacred ground. When I fly that plane, call the angel flight. Got a hero riding with us tonight. Between heaven and earth, you're never alone.
For those of you in physical attendance, or for those of you who are still joining, heed my words. Welcome, everyone. We are all here today to speak of and remember those of us who have left this world too soon, with too much left undone. We are here to make sure their memory never fades. We remember why we are all here, why this community is such a prestigious place, and why all of us came here in the first place, and have done so much for it, with hours spent relentlessly, and days going by where we worry about what is happening the next day. This in of itself shows us what it means the Cav to us. Before we begin the eulogies, and before we begin the stories, I would like to introduce myself to those of you who do not know me, for those who will be listening, and for those who were welcomed into the yellow and black later in life. My name is Sergeant Jake Grimm. I'm the current platoon sergeant of 3rd Platoon Bravo, as well as the master EOD instructor. Most importantly, I am known by a different title among my brothers. I am known as the Reclusiarch. This title, from wherever you may know it, is a title that is never given lightly. Their job within their homes is to uphold their brothers and tell their stories, as well as reinforce the armor of the chapter or platoon that they represent. They tell stories of war and remember those that have fallen, making sure that no one's memories fade away. This is the job that I have taken upon my shoulders. It is the reason I stand before all of you today at this memorial, to bring forth the stories and accolades of those who have fallen for all to see. Behind me sits a monument to our fallen, a tribute of stone and steel, representing the love we have for them and the respect they have earned from our community as a whole. The fires that burn upon the pedestals is the same as in their hearts and ours. It represents the fervor to fight and improve, to meld and sharpen, to build and reinforce all of our values and the standard they all held so high, and what they gave to us to carry into the day. The following will be the eulogies of our fallen, the stories of what they left behind and what they mean to all of us, to show but glimpses into their lives, into their motivations, into their values that led them to be the heralds of the shield we all carry so dearly. The first on the list is Brigadier General Crazy. Now, I do not have something written for him because I did not know him well enough, but I do believe that our own General Chance does have something to say on his behalf. General Chance, if you would join me at the front and speak of your brothers.
Dear son, I know I ain't written. Sitting here tonight alone in the kitchen, it occurs to me. I might not.
Good evening, everybody. I hope everybody can hear me fine.
Yes, sir.
Today I'm here to talk to you about Robert Foster, aka Crazy. Back in the day, in the second iteration of the 7th Cav, We didn't use realistic names like we do now. It was more of a internet environment where people were tried to be as anonymous as possible, not like the Cav of today. It was a new organization. It was a new thing. And General Crazy was totally devoted to the Cav. When I joined the Cav in 2008, he had already, along with General Plumley, had the thing going for about a year. And there wasn't really anything that General Crazy didn't do for the Cav. He ran S1, he was the chief of staff, kept everybody in line, he ran boot camps. All of this not being in the best of health. Due to a lung condition, General Crazy had to have a lung transplant. It was this condition that ultimately took his life. I remember the evening. It was like many that he had spent with me sitting in Ventrilo or TeamSpeak or whatever the software we were using at the time was to communicate. We would sit in there and do mil packs and process boot camp entries and do all those backside things that a lot of people never see. But on this particular night, I'm sitting in there in the office, and it's General Dog, General Plumley, myself. When General Plumley comes on, and you could tell he's upset that he had just gotten a call from Crazy's mother that he had passed away due to complications that occurred during surgery. And he was the first Cav member we lost. We've lost several now, having been around for so long, but he was the first. And for a lot of people, they didn't know how to handle it. They didn't know how to take it. It was a new experience. But General Plumley was determined that he would be honored, and he would never, ever be forgotten. On most of our game servers, there's usually a running scroll dedicated to General Crazy. He was as being the first fallen. And he would be very, very proud of the Cav that exists today. He had a little bit of jokester in him. He loved telling these off-color jokes. but at the same time, when it came time to do Cav business, it was time to do Cav business. He didn't put up with no foolishness. And he is sorely missed today. Thank you.
Thank you, General. The next two fallen are Brigadier General Stephen Tracer and Colonel Anthony Avails, both of which Chance knew better than any of us here, and that their stories still need to be told.
Well, Stephen Tracer. Stephen Tracer came into the Cav like a lot of my compatriots of the time. We all came in together. We started out in COD 4 and COD 5, which you know, we don't play anymore, but until General Tracer came around, we didn't really have a standard by which we held people accountable. Yeah, we listed articles of the UCMJ, and they were pretty much directly out of what you would read in an Army manual. But until General Tracer decided to put some thought into it and how it applied to the Cav, we didn't have anything that really applied to us. And he took the time and the effort to mold the UCMJ that we currently have to the Cav. And it was his firm belief that everybody in the Cav deserved due process. Everybody, no matter what they had done or the infraction that they were accused, there needed to be a process involved. And it's thanks to him that we do have a lot of the standard procedures that we have today. General Tracer passed away from ALS November 18th, 2017. He left behind a family. He had a wife and two kids. He has also sorely missed. Colonel Anthony Aviles, otherwise known as Raven, because he was a big Baltimore Ravens fan. He's from Baltimore. Again, he's one of my contemporaries from COD 4. He served as 2nd Battalion Commander for a while. He served as Commander of the COD 4 Company for a while. Tony was a jokester, a prankster. He loved everything about the Cav. Constantly was trying to keep people. We would go through instances where morale would be low, and you can always count on Tony to come up with a cornbread joke. And there's an inside joke. Some of you may be aware of that joke. And don't ask me to explain it. It's outside my realm, but he could always be counted on to pick up your spirits, give you advice when you needed it. Tony died of complications of not taking care of himself, as a lot of us do. He was just in overall general poor health, overweight, and he had a heart condition. And it caught up with him. I'd like to say that he'd be proud of the Cav, as it is true. Really all I got to say about those guys.
Thank you, Trance. The next fallen brother that we will speak of, his tribute was written by previous Command Sergeant Major Argus, and was given to me to read today. This is Command Sergeant Major Ron Cold. Ron, you see, also known by as Ronnie, was born the 14th of September on 1946 and passed away from this world on the 27th of September in 2012 at an age of 66. He served 23 years in the armed forces, with 2 tours in Vietnam as a CB, and retired as a captain in the Armored Division in 1990. He joined the Cav in the 20th of June in 2010, was promoted to Specialist, then to Sergeant Major, and then appointed as Command Sergeant Major on the 16th of December 2010. Ronnie Cold was always a straight shooter who had time to listen to anyone. He'd hear you out, and in his deep southern drawl would dispense wisdom and advice, and sometimes some hard truth. He wasn't one to pull punches, but he always did it in a way that left you feeling better about yourself. He was as dedicated to the Cav as a person could be. He and General Chance ran S1 for a Cav that numbered around 300 people by themselves, which is an enormous task. He spent almost all of his waking hours devoted to making this place better. He often took the opportunity to speak to new recruits and made it a point to give the final speech at boot camps regularly. Ronnie never believed the Cav was just about playing games. He believed the Cav was a place where members could learn the new skills they needed and could develop into better people. And he worked harder than anyone at instilling this philosophy into new members. He believed we all had a deep responsibility to live the values of the regiment in order to continue to pass these down to the newer members and keep spirit of the organization alive. Despite being terminally ill with cancer, kept good humor and worked tirelessly for the Cav right to the end. He was and continues to be an inspiration to those that knew him. Corporal Tars Tarkus. Unfortunately, I cannot bring forth a story that described them in deep detail. But what I do have is as much as I could find and as much as I could muster. Tars was born in 1961 on the month of February and passed away in 2013 in the month of December at the age of 52. They had joined the Cav in 2012 on the month of August and led a simple life with pride and honor. They reached the rank of corporal and completed a number of operations in a time where operations carried a significant weight and where the pressure was immense and where keeping your brothers up top and taking care of them was prime priority. Though they did not do much past what unfortunately took them from us, the memory of their actions for those affected will never truly fade. Those that know them will remember their names, and so it is today we will also remember their names. We will keep them in our hearts and in our minds as an example to follow and continue to raise the mantle higher so they can see us from the halls of the fallen. Specialist Rhea Novak was born in May in the year 1990 and died September of the year 2016 at an age of 26. She joined the Cav in November 2015. She was the wife of James Novak, another Cav member, and she was taken too early in her time with too much potential left. She was lost to us during an incident that broke few and wounded many in many ways. From what records we had, she was a fantastic pilot and a fantastic person to have at your back. She will be missed as much as any other of our fallen, and we remember her name in the fires of our hearts next to every other trooper that we will lose and have lost. Sergeant Kyle McGahey. Kyle was born in May 1987 and died in June 2018. Passed away at the age of 31 and joined the Cav in May 2017. He had reached the rank of sergeant and was an SL for the majority of his time. He completed a number of NCAPS courses and allowed for the constant training of his brothers to a higher mantle than anyone knew we could. He was a ranger and the very first sapper, and led three different departments of S3, including being the bridgehead for the S3 NCOIC. The man was an example to follow and a caring SL of all of his brothers. Kyle was a good man, a great man, and a great inspiration for what it meant to be in the Cav. He was always reaching for more, helping anyone he could, and teaching every hour of every day. You can ask a number of people here, and they will tell you that he was the inspiration that brought them into the cavalry to start. He created a number of ideas, from mortars to explosive usages, infantry movements, and heavy weapons. He made the Cav a great place to be, and was always there to be a rock for you to lean on in your darkest of times. Following his example caused a number of leaders to spring forward, myself included, and learning of his passing hurt a number of people in ways they never thought possible. Writing of his actions and the lives that he touched would take hours, if not days. And I have never seen a man more deserving of the lifetime award that he carries around his neck. Something that we can all strive to be. Our better selves, and in turn, paid forward to our brothers, following Kyle's example, and upholding who we hold close here so that this loss never occurs again. Now, these fallen brothers, fallen angels of the Cavalry, are the reason we all stand here today. While we all hold ourselves to such a standard, while we have what we have in our lives, and while we all continue to live to their example, so that one day we will see them again at the gates of Valhalla and join them in celebrating not only their lives, but our own as well. At this point, I would implore that all of you come forward and pay respects at the tombs of our fallen. Touch the stone and steel. Allow it to strengthen your hearts and clear your minds of doubt, so that we can go forward with vigor and determination to continue holding the mantle of responsibility given to us by our fallen. We will start with the guard, followed by the rest of the attendees following behind. All of those to my left may begin moving forward. Staff Sergeant Thor, lead your column forward.
She was planning a welcome home barbecue, green bean casserole, grandma's recipe. There was a knock on the door around 2 o'clock. Two uniforms and her heart stopped. Yellow ribbon round an oak tree, blowing in the breeze.
Here's to the honor guard, return to your positions.
Up there, but they sure left a hole down
We will now salute these heroes of the cavalry. The fire of their hearts and the sound of our rifles to christen the very air with our presence, so as to let the heavens know that we are still here and fighting as much as they would be. Taps will now be played, after which the 21 gun salute will be fired. Honor Guard, present arms. Ready, aim, fire. Aim, fire. Aim, fire. Shoulder, arm. Now, we have one monument here that has no name. The centerpiece of this assembly we have behind us. It stands as a testament to our brothers who never came home, were never claimed, or were never found to have been lost. This is the tomb of the unknown trooper, where those who had been lost and never found are kept in memory in tales of heroism. We cannot always be able to see what happens past our lives. Sometimes we are lucky enough to make an impact on someone so great it stops the dark thoughts from creeping in. But there are also times when we are not so lucky. This tomb represents those who have been lost to memory and time, and stands to remind us that life is precious and fragile, and that we are all the keepers of our brothers, and that the effort is never wasted, for that is what all the others here would want. We will now salute these lost to time with a cannon barrage, with a 4-gun salute from our own 1st Platoon Bravo Troop. Troop D, move to your cannon. Those of you who have volunteered for tank gunners, fall out and move to your tanks. Lucy, Barton, fall out, take the last two tanks. Before the four guns go off, our own Alpha Company have come together to do the missing man formation. They will do a flyover of the tomb, which will then be followed by the four gun salute. Those of you who are gunners, raise your barrels to the sky so that the heavens may hear your thunder. Brothers who are not on the guns, face the tomb and present arms. For today is a great day. Gunners, ready, aim, fire. Aim, fire. Aim, fire. Look to the skies, my brother, for the angels hath come. Thou shalt never be forgotten.
Okay, that was actually pretty dope. That was actually pretty fucking dope.
Gunners, you may dismount and return to formation. This concludes memorial part of our ceremony. Now we'll be going into a more positive part, if we are able. General Chance, you have the recipients.
Yeah, regiment, normally at this time we would award the memorial medals that are named after Crazy and Cold Blood. Due to recent events, I haven't been able to make the citations. So I apologize. I will announce the recipients of those awards tomorrow when I have the citations made and mill packs can add them. But I will. I'd like to leave you with a couple of stories, if I could, about Sergeant Major Colt.
By all means.
The first one's gonna make you laugh. The second one, it might make you cry, but in a good way. As the statement was read by Sergeant Grimm said, we used to sit up till 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning sometimes, processing mill packs and talking, shooting the breeze. Every now and then we'd play a game together. And where my computer sits in my house, there's a window to that looks over, out into my front yard. And right underneath the window, I have a little landscape pond with a fountain. And in the spring and in the fall, try to save a little bit of money, I open the window and try to let some fresh air in the house. And if you're in my TeamSpeak channel and I got my voice activation set wrong, sometimes you can hear the trickle of that fountain. And Ronnie used to joke, he's like, "Dadgummit, General, I gotta go to the bathroom again. I wish you'd turn that fountain off." And he would come back and he says, "If you don't turn that fountain off, I'm gonna come pee in your pond." And he used to always give me grief about the fountain in my pond. The second is right before he passed away. Talked about dedication to the bitter end. I was talking to him on a daily basis when he went in the hospital for the last time. He had to go back to the hospital because, being the stubborn old man that he was trying to work in the yard, and the cancer had eaten up the bone in his forearm, and it just broke. It just snapped on him, and he ended up back in the hospital. And he calls me. And he says, "Hey, General Chance," he says, what kind of laptop do I need to do mill packs?" And I said, "What do you mean?" He says, "Well, I'd like to buy a laptop so I can sit here in the hospital and do mill packs." He was very dedicated to this place. And I'm sorry that a lot of you guys didn't get to meet him. That's all I got, Sarge.
Thank you, Chance. This concludes our ceremony today, but I do not bid you to leave with closed minds and wounded hearts. Leave here today with strengthened wills and burning spirits. Continue to uphold your brothers, for they are the armor that we all wear. And when that armor fails, we will all fall together. Take that home with you today and live to the best of your life. Be your best selves and remember this one phrase: long live the Cavalry.
Hear, hear.
That point, the ceremony has concluded. You are all free to roam about. The server will be closing in 10 minutes. Recording will be over. Thank you all for attending.